everybody on Mars.
And I'm Chippy.
And this is Terrell. And you're watching the Puzzle Kids Cooking Show. Hey everybody, I'm Mars, and welcome back to the Puzzle Kids Cooking Show, where we help our brother Terrell, who's autistic, make some of his favorite meals. So, today's menu is Picky Eaters. Most children, when they're young, are picky eaters, but for a kid on the spectrum, it's hard for them to tell you what they want to eat all the time if they're nonverbal. In this case, Terrell is semi-verbal, though. But he doesn't speak in full sentences yet, either. So, he points at the food and tells us what he wants to eat. So, Chef Tiffany, what are we making today? Get started.
Today, we are making Terrell's and myself favorite dish. Mac and cheese.
Not my favorite.
You'll need pre-cooked macaroni noodles.
Macaroni noodles?
Mild cheddar cheese. Flour. Milk. Butter. And onion. Sad black pepper. You'll also need a whisk. Mixing spoons and bowls to put your food in. While Chef Sproul and I put everything together, Chef Margaret will give you today's sidebar.
Okay, today's sidebar is siblings dealing with an autistic individual or loved one. Just to get that out the way so it's not like. Okay, in the meantime, one, explain to your children what autism is and what it means for them as siblings so the sibling can have a full understanding of what they're dealing with. Children form a relationship with their siblings. Just because they're autistic doesn't mean they don't fully understand. I have a great relationship with my older brother, Javon, and he's autistic also. And remember that communication is key. It truly is. Oh my. And last, make sure you have a parent and me day with your child. It helps them to feel part of the family and gives them much needed time with you. And that's today's cycle. Well, if that doesn't work, you know, you can have your siblings or your children do it, you know, sibling and me time. I like spending time with my younger brother, too. Well, except for the older one. I can relate to that much more. You might want to put it all on your burner.
Right now, I'm making a bechamel sauce for mac and cheese. First, I start off with some butter. Then, I slowly add flour.
This is getting interesting already. I've never seen these cheese sauce flavors before. Yeah. Or maybe you can have Chef Terrell keep whisking while you add the ingredients.
There you go, Chef Terrell. Chef Terrell, mix. Now,
careful.
Now add some milk.
I think you'll get more interested in the mac and cheese, too. Look, it's cheese. Cheese for me, please.
And now Chef Terrell will mix it up. Go on, Chef Terrell. And I'll slowly add flour. Yep.
much steak and gravy and cheese. Look, Steve.
Bye bye.
Now, if I had some drums right now, I'd be making a pretty big one. There you go, add the cheese.
Do it like that.
Let's finish off the cheese.
Well, we gotta watch it closely. The cheese.
As you remember from our pizza episode, Chef Terrell loves cheese very much. This is why we never see it in a week. But I think now it's time to add the macaroni noodles, Chef.
Okay.
Personal time with Chef Terrell. Bye. Bye. Say bye, Terrell.
Bye, Terrell.